Hello, my name is Creostix, and welcome back to Deus Ex. Wait. Well, that's a start. Listen. Okay, so that's one down. And a second one down. Accomplished. I have done the airfield a number of times in my time, but again, it's been a long time since I played the game last anyway. And then on top, my memories of Lebedev Airfield are, like, vague. Meaning, I remember a large area that has, I honestly thought there was one robot, not two, so that's, so. Oh, goody. One lockpick, four things of something. I forget if an EMP grenade would help there. It might. Let's see. And we obviously should probably break the boxes via ranged stuff here because okay, there's at least one clip item. What can I do to I can take the clip item, plus I do not need the knife. It super just comes up all the time. Okay. Oh, it takes my bioelectricity at first, huh? Does it actually do damage then? Slightly, I think, yeah. So 32, 44, 45, 59. Okay, now it hurts a little bit, but I call worth it, it's fine. Cool. I took more damage than I'd like to, but we'll get to a med bot after the mission anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. Honestly, I kind of like the idea that I need to actually find healing items in the level, including and not limited to 40s and sodas and such. So it just adds immersion. I kind of almost like it is the wrong word, but it does, give agency to the game world, if that makes sense. Again, same thing. If I need a bigger clip, it's gonna be in the pistol, because that's, of the stuff I'm using, is the one that I take for close combat if I have to. Or at least the... Oh, for fuck. So, that's an alarm, which is bad. It's fine. See, it's all good. One has to have the courage to try, you see, so it's all fine. The problem being, I seem to remember there's actually a key for the watchtowers anyway, so I might be kind of wasting my time though, so let's actually consider that as a notion. So I always press the wrong button. I take a screenshot instead of a quick load. That's I'll need to learn that one of these days. But yeah, I just remembered, I feel like I can open the doors via key at some point, so it's not worth it to spend a lockpick on that stuff. What's you? Ambrosia, can hopefully, if something goes wrong, proud JL. Sure. I'm trying to think of JLs. Like, I do know the story, like, the broad strokes of it. But I, of course, try to not say it out loud. Because that would be... Oh, there's a third robot. Oh, goody. I hope it works. Looks kind of promising. Oh, there's one more. How? I did not remember there being this many robots. Fuck. Yep, nope, I can't accept that though. Okay, try again. So, take the data pad, cube, or whatever, and let's have another go at this. Cube, right. Which, it isn't a cube, but it's a cube. Sure. I took damage this time around. I wouldn't want to, but nah. Okay, somewhere here there is a robot. There's also people, I think, patrolling the area in some form, so... Careful is the word. There's an alarm button on a cargo box. That's actually kind of it's impressive, I suppose. Or then again, not really. Like, while some of the phones and such seem a little 1999 in the desks and such, it is true that, like, there's no reason why there wouldn't be a button which would then just, like, infrared or radio or whatever its way into the main... frame of the alarm system. Fuck. Fuck. Okay. I know. Can we not? It's in such close quarters, I don't have time to lock onto it, and then it just goes to hell. Plus, I've taken too much damage to withstand the attack anymore. Okay, that's supposed... Yeah, now it's gone. Okay, I think I saw a couple of boxes of something. I realize it's again dark. It's dark for me too. One, it builds atmosphere. Second, the enemies see the flashlight, so I'm using it sparingly. Plus, I'm actually up out of the... What was the other item? There you go. Prod charger. Cool. Okay. Let's get some bearings in here, right? So a couple of lights there. There's a, like a small building in that direction. I thought I heard something, but I might be mistaken. Cool. Here we are. Ah. Same thing as before, though. The crossbow, while not being lethal, is one of the better ways to get rid of these people, so... just need to hide when I use it, and I actually need to get behind a corner before I do that. Oh, that'll work too, yeah. Oh, come on. One more robot, Jesus Christ. That's too far. I don't want to risk it. I would lose the... I wonder if I'll be... Nope, I won't. It's just gonna go, yeah. This is gonna be tricky. At some point, I'll need to check what's in these cargo, you know, truck parts, but I'll worry about that later. Okay. The problem here is the dude in the inside could absolutely hear me if he gets alarmed. Robot, please. I did not remember there being so many robots.
They found us. That's him. He's a cop. Stay cool.
Well, the robot doesn't care, so that's good. Since I have all the lambs, right? I know just a good way to use one, because I want to get inside these things, and instead of using two lockpicks, I'll instead can I get some help getting in? Here we are. Ooh, drank darts. That's actually totes worth it, for sure. Here we are. Sabot shells, actually also worth it. It'll be a bit since I start using them, but they'll add up because they're like the high damage. Well, let me rephrase that. They are the there. 12 gauge shotgun shells surrounding a solid core of tungsten that can punch through all but the thickest hardened steel armor at close range. However, its ballistic profile will result in minimal damage to soft targets. So, you know, that's the... So, not high damage as such, more like a armor-piercing, but keep in mind that armor-piercing has less effect on soft targets, so... Ooh!
That should make sure you and I won't miss any shots. I've notified the recovery team. One barrel left. We think this one may actually be on Lebedev's jet.
Cool. Okay, so... Let's take some stuff. Oh, there's still one more. Yeah, that's true. Ooh, biocell. I will use that. Also, let's see if I can catch whatever falls out of this one. I did. Very proud of that one. I know there's that pipe over there. That's a pretty good way in, but let's explore a little first. And, okay, there. There's probably a ladder or something, right? Also, why are there TNT boxes just like floating in the water? Is there like a function to that fact? There you go. I thought I couldn't get up, but I can, so. Okay, so let's see if we can Ah, for fuck's sake. Lot of cameras. For sure. Interesting.
Scanning area. Target acquired.
It's all fine. I'll just hide here. Until the action music goes away. Okie dokie, so... Luckily I had the aware of it all to go get the buckshot shotgun. Otherwise I would be in a bit of a trouble with the close combat stuff here.
I got this. God damn.
Care to die? Like, how many shotgun hits can you take? Seriously, thank you. Gotta be careful with the towers, with the alarms, because they, yeah. Will turn bad if I go near. And there's an alarm on. Okay, a little messy, but we got through it, so that's the important bit. Again, checking the, I think there might be something over there, but without the, movement upgrades, that's, not quite a jump I'm probably able to do, so. Okay. Okay, so there's a dude. I can probably just hide behind him and just cattle prod him as well. Shouldn't be a problem. I think, assuming there's no one else. Hi.
I saw that's him. He's a cop.
Oh, fuck. I assumed when the steps happened that he would have turned away, but he didn't. So, try again. It's not that hard, too, but it's just, stealth games are not my forte. I like this one, though, a lot, mind you, but it's still just not... I don't have the instincts for a stealth game. There you go. Cool, and then let's actually make a different hard save this time around. Shouldn't really matter where. And give us a moment. Cool. I needed to check something, but here we are. Need to just close the thing there and move them. Yeah. Cool. I feel like there is this one. Cool. So the reality is, I will have less trouble if I go by. Actually, I think that's I think there's skill points to be gained if I go to the dive, you know, into the place route. I'm actually kind of thinking that that might be the case, but I get more items, more explosives, and such if I go through the people route. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to get the skill points via, like, the I have now explored this place and then back. So first go here. Aqualung on, because I need it to be on. Even with the Aqualung, I remember this dive being a little tricky at points, so. Or I might be mistaken as well. But basically, if I go far enough, there should be also this one. Reload weapon mod in a sewer pipe, because of course there's one. Same thing as before. Buckshot would be otherwise good. However, the problem being that I will not use, I won't be using it, you know, in the future. So it's gonna be either the Trank Dart or the pistol. And again, the pistol is the one I need. If I need a quick reload in anything, it's gonna be in that. So and even if I don't get a skill point reward, I might be just misremembering this. It's still a fact that I now got the reload clip thing, so that's good. Okay, let's see. Oh. Why do I... How do I remember this being a way into the actual place then? It's... I mean, there's a loading screen and everything in between there. What am I misremembering here? Hmm. I have a feeling I'm not misremembering the notion of get up there, but... How odd. I would find it somehow odd that if, like, it seems very unlikely that they would have, like, changed it for the Game of the Year edition or something. Or the, whatever was the final version of the game, because I played the, like, 0.1 version with a big cardboard box, but still. I remember being able to get in there, but apparently no. That's odd. Well, at least we got the reload mod, right? Hmm. So I don't need the Aqualung after all here, because... that's so... That's very confusing. I was so sure, you know? Like... It's ridiculous how sure I was. That's a way to get in. And I don't see, like, a pumping station, so... Well, let's go in the main way, then. I'll check the towers after I'm done with the place, because I'm hoping that that by that time the turrets won't care about me anymore. Here goes. Well, I can absolutely take that down. Come on. Come on.
God damn.
Hi. Why you can't hit me from there is a mystery to everyone involved, but I'll take it. There. I strafed successfully from their bullets. A tiny alarm, but you know, we got through it all fine. So and they're unconscious as well, so you know, everybody wins. Everyone has a security tower key too. Hi. Ooh. As I was talking about just random healing items. There we are. Ooh. Same goes for this one. It's important to drink enough water, you see, to have healing. That's 1.10 times. Important stuff this. There we are. Out of water, although I... Well... microwave, stuff and stuff... Soy food. And that's... It's also important to eat, so soy food healed for 5. Oh, actually that's true, this dartboard... You can literally take the darts, so you just add them to your ammo account. That's actually pretty fun. Okay, so... I'm gonna hope that I got all of them already from here, but... Better safe than sorry, right? Cool. Excellent. Right. So that's 3 multi-tools. I have no idea if I have the capacity to know the code to it, though. It's not gonna be... No. Okay, let's... Open this up, though. See what's what. Okay, so similar thing as before, right? There's the notion of one pick unlocked hangar code 5914. Okay. Medkit. So, one pick, right? So, same idea as before, I think. Some reason I felt the need to maybe check under the pillows for, like, treasure, but I don't know. Then again, it would be much like this game to do that, but yeah. So, if I do this right, I should be able to get all 3 with 1 lamb. So, about here... then just run. Yep. And I literally get one more lamb from here, so we are already at a net gain from that. By if we pick up anything else. I don't need the flares, they are kind of almost useless. Darts, so there, we are on a net positive. Plus multi-tool, which I have max of, right? But bio cell and darts as a literal net gain, so cool. And sure, getting into here, you used one lockpick, but I saved three multi-tools by finding out the hangar code, so. Which was 5914, right? Yeah. Okay. Now we're this far. But yeah, I super have the memory of coming up the sewers from, to go there. I have no idea why, that doesn't work. I'm very confused.
You can relax, JC. I told the troops to stand down. That's right. I'm working for the NSF. I'll meet you at the 747.
Mm-hmm. Paul, no! Let's not have a talk yet. I'm gonna run away from you. Let's go to a dark corner where we can talk in peace. Here.
Excellent work. I underestimated your abilities.
You work for the NSF?
Listen to what I've got to say. We don't have much time.
You got that right. UNATCO will have a team here in a few minutes.
The Grey Death is a man-made virus. Everyone up to the president is at UNATCO's mercy as long as UNATCO controls the supply of Ambrosia.
You believe that?
We have proof. We need to get the Ambrosia to Hong Kong. Heard of Tracer Tong? He can help us synthesize it ourselves.
You better step away from the jet. Your boss is my next objective.
Join us, JC. Talk to Lebedev. He can convince you.
So. Paul is working for the NSF all along. Who are the good guys? Oh no. It's so confusing. Luckily, oh, hi.
Hold fire.
It's curious that they still say, like, terrorists. So they're friendly, but terrorists.
Easy, we don't want any trouble.
Well, your friends did, but luckily I didn't kill all of them. Only, two, three-ish. And then the robots, but that doesn't count. I'll just, I'm looking for a couple of... I'm seriously wondering. I have a memory of using the sewers to get in, but... Especially because they have a loading screen in between there. It's gotta be possible, and I'm sure...
Hey, you're the guy the Feds sent? I have something for you.
How do you know anything about the Feds?
Oh, Lebedev, all his people right now? They're running around like ants thinking it's gonna be a raid. Rich bastard probably has some kind of drug deal about to happen. Anyway, filch this stuff from a guy's locker. I'm selling a recoil weapon mod for 400. I also have some shotgun shells I'll give you for 300.
Recoil mod, sure.
Here's 400 for the recoil weapon mod.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. Okay. Oh, that's actually probably what was in the UNATCO locker too. Recoil instead of silencer. Details. Recoil mod. Basically anything probably would work, but I actually do kind of care about the recoil in the sniper rifle in a manner of speaking, so go for it. The difference is very tiny, but it's still like stuff, right? So also friendly robot, cool. But again, I'm so goddamn sure I've entered this place via the sewers, but man. Question, is there anything...
You decide to join up?
Time will tell. 747 diagram, cool. Rockets, cool. Totes worth it to explore a bit. Excellent. And this one? Stop as well. Accuracy. Ammo. So the thing is, I intend to at some point be so good at rifles that it's going to offset the accuracy anyway from that. Whereas I actually need accuracy in especially the trank darts. And pistols as well, but basically both are true, so. Cool. I think I'm ready to just go. I'm so obsessed with the sewer entrance though. Like how it's super supposed to be a thing. I have such a memory of using it. And it's bothering me that I'm not seeing like
Hurry
a man.
Up. The UNATCO security squad won't be far behind.
I know. But I'm super annoyed that I'm not seeing a manhole or something here, which I don't know. Am I just imagining that I've done that like 10 times? By some goddamn... I don't know. Okay. Oh well. Progress though. Let's keep going forward. Ooh, all the 40s. You don't mind if I just like right quick? I mean, I'm probably gonna just get to the mod or the med bot before I do any more combating, but still. I saw, yeah. It's important to eat while you drink, or at least it's, you know, probably smart. Like, if you're drinking to begin with, then it's probably good to eat as well. That's usually the thing. Okie dokie. Not seeing too much either, but it'll there you go. Oh, I remember. Woo!
That's the last one. Good work.
Ooh. Hi. Recharge. Thanks. Okay, so way back when, right? There used to be a way to just, like, inch your way through the force field here to pick up the augmentation thing. I am not sure if it's possible here. But I remember doing it. It was just glitchy enough that allowed one to get that canister without actually opening the force field. But it doesn't look like it's happening though. Like, if it's possible to do this here, I don't know how, but that's fine. Assuming I don't have the augmentation yet, let's just take it. The, honest way. There we are. Which is EMP shield and ballistic protection. Yes, I actually want that. I do want ballistic protection, for sure. and I'll be upgrading it as well, so I'll be using the upgrade thing to that. It's a simple thing, but it's I do find it useful, so. Because bullets be flying in this game every once in a while, it's just how it goes. When you say door strength 100, does it withstand a lamb? No. Assault rifle, not as such interesting, I think. Again, I will never need the combat knife. It would be cool if the game wouldn't, well, you know. Complaining about a really old pioneering game, right? But it would be cool if the game wouldn't automatically take the combat knife when they everyone has one, and I'm like, I don't want one. Oh, that's Lebedev, cool. I could probably have just reached beyond that point anyway, but eh. So before I talk to Lebedev, I want to get all the stuff. Yeah, that's actually, I should probably just, I basically wasted a lamb for no reason, so. There you go. I'll check the front one more time to see if there's anything interesting here. Nothing that immediately springs to mind there. Don't see much here either. Cool. So that should just, yeah. Decker, Killian, Canister, Decker wasn't barred, but, fuck. Okay, I could have just opened it with this one then. Ugh. Ah, whatever. Fine. Hi.
I surrender.
What?
Easy now, Agent. UNATCO has a policy against killing unarmed prisoners. We have much to learn from each other.
We're assuming control of the airfield. The vaccine will be returned to the international authorities.
Don't you want to hear why your brother came over to our side?
He makes his own decisions.
You know he wouldn't betray UNATCO without a reason.
Unless for treason.
Good work. Now finish the job.
Hi.
He surrendered. He's an unarmed prisoner. UNATCO policy protects him.
Terminate the prisoner, Agent. If you are too afraid, you are ordered to return to base on Manderly's authority. There is a helicopter waiting.
Mm-hmm. So here's the thing.
If you know something, just tell me.
The question you've got to ask, I'm surprised you haven't, is the obvious one. Who am I? Who made me, and for what purpose?
Video game designer.
Brief me on my augmentations. Get to the point.
Return to base, Agent Denton. I will handle this.
Your parents were murdered precisely because they could have told you the correct answer to that question.
That's a pretty big claim.
You didn't have parents. The ones you knew were employees. You were made by a couple of technophiles so crazed for power that they would control not only governments and people, but the chemistry of our bodies as well.
Ooh.
Leave us, Agent. Now. I have the command here now. Congratulations, Agent. You are one of us after all. I confess I had my doubts. Your helicopter is waiting at the airfield.
So the point there was, that's a very good example of one that
I've... We can say what we like in the paperwork.
Cool. That I've played this game a number of times, and I know that by killing Lebedev there, we don't really change the course of the story at all, but we do get 1,000 more credits with which we can then buy more weapon mods and such. So in terms of at the altar of like min-maxing the game, that's why that happens. Because if we don't do that, we just lose 1,000 credits for no real like a story-related reason per se, because Lebedev isn't important in any way beyond this point. It's just, I think Navarre just kills him anyway if I leave, so. It's better that I get the money with which to do the good in the world instead of Ancient Navarre. That's the, because he was gonna die anyway there is the point, so. That's the unfortunate reality of that.
See to the helipad. We know your brother was here. He's gone, but we will find him.
Oh, goody. So question, did you now turn off the cameras in the corners? Because I'd love to very quickly check the towers for like loot and stuff. Hi.
All clear, sir.
Cool. It looks like you probably did. Yeah. Let's, for the sake of argument, just check what's here. Ah, wrong button. Multi-tools, cool. That's actually super good. Now I don't probably need to hack this stuff anymore because I'll check one of them, but basically it should be pointless now when we are like, they've like neutralized the cameras as such anyway, and ergo they shouldn't have any. Yeah, it just off and turrets. So, but the multi-tools there do hint at the notion that I should probably check the other corners as well and then go back to base. That went, you know, it could have gone even better, but it went okay, all things considering. Hi.
We've disabled the security grid.
So it seems. I'll just check the corner of the tower and the thing. It'll be important. Come on. Here we go. Hop. Sniper rifle and binoculars. I'll take the ammo for sure. Why not? I'm still bothered by the fact the diving into the place didn't work. I feel so strongly that's a way in, but. Here we go. Ooh, there's a box and everything. With ammo. Buckshot and binoculars again. Everyone has a, every spot has a binoculars, it seems. Cool. That's good. I think there's at least one or two more. Hi, Herman. I'll just, you know. Ooh, here's the gap gun. And, you know, obviously we get rockets out of it. So if you didn't choose the gap gun, I think that is the first point in the game where you can get it, which is a bit risky considering stuff and things, but if you do get here, you know, before going in the actual air hangar, right, it does, you know, make dealing with the robots so much more simple, just because lambs are tricky. Perfectly usable, but tricky. Because you would need to basically just either use them as proximity mines with cargo boxes, or just throw them and hope. Another recoil mod and ammo. Give us a moment. There you are. Cool. Totally worth it, this little exploration trip. Okay, that's all of it, I think. Herman, do you want to have a talk?
Magali has assigned me the peacekeeping occupation of the airport.
Standard procedure, it appears. I'm sure we can count on you.
I want to be the one to execute Lebedev.
Some bad news. I already took him out.
Yes, of course. Congratulations, Agent.
Hey, about my brother.
A shame that we have to track down and kill one of our most advanced agents. At least we have one of you left.
Don't you think we should give Paul a chance to explain himself? He's been with UNATCO for years.
Only one thing can happen when you break your oath to the Coalition.
Oh, goody. And it's super not creepy that Gunther and Navarre just like, we want to kill people, ah. Jock, hi.
Gunther told me about Paul.
It's true. Paul's been working for the NSF.
This is gonna shake up the Coalition, JC. I don't know if you realized how important your brother was.
Mm. Coalition will recover. I'm not so worried about the Coalition.
UN officials will probably get involved. You'll have to keep your head down if you're gonna come through this in one piece. Sure you're ready to head back to base?
Now, yes. I just checked everything.
I'm ready. Let's move out.
Get in.
And a job well done. Well done is maybe a bit of an exaggeration, but job done. And, you know, the important part is we had a good time doing it. Looks empty. Hi. Ooh, Sabot cell. Sabot or Sabot shells? I super have never heard anyone say that word out loud, but, you know. Nothing else here, though. Well, I can't pick up the ammo, is the point, so. Cool. Check behind the... Because I think in the first level there's some boxes here as well, and I probably missed them then, but details. The stuff always changes a bit when you come and go these places.
Manderly's pleased that you followed orders. He wants to see you.
Yay!
We got the news. Nobody really believes it.
Mm-hmm.
Too bad about Paul. Guess that goes to show we can't be too sure of anyone.
Well, we can't also be too sure of the place we work at. It may, maybe, because Paul seems like a stand-up guy. That was a tricky loading screen. I'm not sure which way is the correct way now. Cool. I could empty the water fountain, but I can just.
Manderly wants to see you. You know the drill.
I super do. But I can just go see a med bot and get my stuff healed, so it's fine. Okie dokie. Hi.
It's a question of who benefits society more. But who decides that? You? It's implicit. I think Paul just had a soft spot for the plague victims. Every human institution is like a pyramid. Those with ability are at the top. They're more important.
Maybe it's the foundation that's important. When the foundation's gone,
they make the decisions. They keep the machine running. Therefore, they must be protected first.
I'm not saying Paul was right.
It's basic tactics. protect your command centers, your airstrips, your industrial zones. It's just the rationing. Seems like the government could pay VersaLife to manufacture more.
Hmm. So, pyramids or not, I think we, you know, there is also something to be said that if the foundations are gone, the top of the pyramid becomes meaningless, just as such. So, it's kind of like an interesting question of like a societal philosophy for sure. Or maybe society is a cube, like the Borg. Just gonna... Ooh, multi-tool. Oh, below the desk, accuracy weapon mod. I will super take one, thanks. The Gep gun doesn't need one, even if it could, because it's practically lock-on, so... Oh, it became a recoil when I picked it up, though. That's weird. Why did I see it was accuracy? Whatever. I'll take it. I was so sure I saw accuracy there, but cool. Alex Jacobson, need to talk about that last mission in person, not Infolink. Come by my office after you've been debriefed by Manderly. Infolink is the stuff that we keep getting the calls in our head, basically. Okay, biocell darts ammo for one pick. Yeah, sure. I actually do need biocells pretty often, so fine. And the last time I tried to explode this cabinet, the people attacked me, so let's maybe avoid that this time.
What kind of pain?
Behind the eyes, a sharp burning, almost electrical.
How's your bioelectric level?
It's always at 100%. I like to stay prepared.
That's probably it right there. Free radicals. You should charge your systems only when they've been significantly drained.
I wasn't informed of that.
It's a lot like an electric razor. If you leave it plugged in all the time, the battery loses its zero point. Just watch your levels.
Interesting. Thanks, Doctor.
Let me know how it goes.
Cool. Hello, Walton Simons.
I saw you listening in. Yes, it's true. I have augmentations like yours.
Don't you work down in Washington?
Actually, I'm the director of FEMA.
Sounds like you wouldn't have much use for physical augmentations.
You underestimate the demands of my work. We deal with every sort of natural and unnatural disaster you can imagine.
But you're the director. You work behind a desk.
Am I behind a desk right now? No, I'm not. That's because we have a situation here in New York. I got to my position because I can fix things. You will see shortly because, as you have probably noticed yourself, this agency is broken and needs an overhaul.
He's a very interesting take on the voice acting. It's very over the top, but I've always liked how Walton Simmons talks, though. A sharp burning, almost electrical. I like it.
Get everybody patched up?
Everybody except you. You look terrible.
I took a few hits this time. Nothing I can't treat myself.
Well, let me know if I can help. As usual, take what you need from the med center.
Thanks.
They just dropped off a few liters of the ambrosia you recovered, by the way.
Good work out there, Denton. I want you to know, we will not let your brother's activity cast its shadow on you.
Yes, sir. I'm grateful for that. I just wish we'd found out sooner.
No harm done. We have you to take his place.
Is a few liters going to be enough?
Well, no one on staff's going to catch Grey Dead this month.
Cool. Again, I'm not sure if I'll find him. I'll come back and hack this one if I don't find a pin code and an account number, basically. So, did I check here? Yes. Check the closets and then go see Manderly. nothing. Boo. Boo, I say. That's something. Lockpick, yep. We'll take.
I can't believe it, JC. What got into Paul?
No,
I guess he got a better offer.
What a blow. I don't know how we'll recover. It's almost like losing a son.
I don't understand it myself, but we've got to go on. Is Manderly available?
Go right in, JC. He has a lot to discuss.
Cool. Hi.
Objective's complete, sir.
Good, good. Here's your op bonus as usual, 1,000 for a flawless performance. You might be interested to know that your tenacity has impressed some very important people.
I only wish to serve the Coalition to the best of my ability.
They have high hopes for you, JC. You understand the importance of loyalty, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Well, that's what seems to be missing in your brother. I hope you'll understand why the Coalition has shut down Paul's augmentations and has activated the kill switch.
Activated what?
He's our enemy now. He's gone, JC. The Coalition wants you to understand that he's just another terrorist, like the ones that have died by your very hand this evening.
Can they really kill him? With the press of a button?
Yes, and you too. So take these orders seriously. They're sending you to Hong Kong.
What about Paul? Will I get to see him again?
Please, just get your equipment and meet our pilot, Jock, at the helipad. You'll need to take out a man called Tracer Tong, Paul's contact in Hong Kong. Prove that they can trust you. JC?
Yes?
It's critical that they trust you.
Right. And that 1,000 we would not have gotten if we would have let Navarre do the kill there, so. So that's the, so he would have died anyway, and we couldn't then use the 100,000 credits to help save the world in our own way, eventually, I hope. Because we are a protagonist, you see, yes.
Then what'd you do?
I chased them into the building.
Weren't you scared?
A little, but when I'm wearing this helmet, I've learned to set aside the instincts of a civilian and be completely professional.
They had assault guns.
Tactically, I had the advantage. It was important to act before the situation changed.
How you troopers do it, I can't imagine.
I still find it funny how
Everest... Everest caught a few slugs, but I had a job to do and I did it.
Amazing.
It was just blind luck that one of the terrorists was carrying orders from Lebedev.
We never would have known about the airlift if you hadn't been so courageous.
Oh, no, no. Don't start that. Just following orders.
And we might never have recovered the shipment. It all depended on you.
Well, I was happy to do my part.
Aw.
That's too bad about Paul.
Agent Denton.
Agent Denton. It is pretty funny how every UNATCO trooper is the same guy, voice and all. Okay, first medbay, because need to get fixed. And need to do stuff. 268 points. Ow. Okay, ballistic protection install, and immediately after, let's just upgrade the whole thing anyway. So, so tech 2, damage from projectiles and bladed weapons is reduced moderately instead of slightly. So, there we go. That is that. I should still have the key to the. Yeah. Reyes did say, quote, take anything you need from the medbay. Oh! Speed enhancement or run silent. Okay, this would need to actually think about a little bit. So. speed and jumping are increased slightly while falling damage is reduced, and then just improve that. Hi, Echeloner. How's your day been? Tell me a story. Welcome. I am doing progress. I just went through the Lebedev airfield and returned back to Natco HQ. Etse. Cool. I'll try to remember, but I have no promises. Etse. I'll try to remember. Yeah. But anyhow, tell me a story. How has your day been? Has your day been okay? I'm making a decision between augmentations here. The other one is sound made while moving is reduced slightly. Rather self-explanatory. So I haven't really had issue as such for alerting people while running. Whereas having speed and reducing falling damage actually sounds more practically useful. So that's... there we go. Day's been good. Played a couple of games in CS and hanged out with brother while playing Modern Warfare with him. Cool. Sounds good. That sounds good. Ooh, medkit. Thank you. I believe I can't go. There's nothing really to, So. It's secure, because I cannot get past that. My day's been pretty much as many of them have been, so nothing to complain about, basically, as such, personally. You know, feeling okay, slept relatively okay, the usual. I'll just take some... well, I'll talk to you first.
How are you holding up?
Fine. I completed the mission objectives.
You were ordered to assassinate a man in cold blood. That must have been difficult.
Not if you pause for a second and think about who he was and what he stood for.
It's a shame when a difference of opinion gets somebody killed. That's all I have to say about that.
Every war is the result of a difference of opinion. Maybe the biggest questions can only be answered by the greatest of conflicts.
Let's hope not, or we're on the brink of another world war. Speaking of which, tell me what you need. I'll load you up.
I do use the Trank darts, though. One rocket or multiple Trank darts. I'll probably end up having a maximum of all of this anyway. Sniper rifle is also good, but not yet, maybe. But it might prove to become good, because I'm actually gonna need them pretty soon, though. Because the thing is, there's gonna be enemies that I'm not gonna try to drank dart, I'm just gonna try to kill them. And I might need sniper rifle bullets.
Sniper rifle, 30-06.
You learn fast. I'm impressed.
Cool. Trank darts, I have 12. A sniper rifle, 47. Sure. I'll somehow manage. Do you want to talk some more?
What do you mean by overhaul?
You will receive a memo in a few days. I am still collecting data.
UNATCO was very effective this evening. We recaptured the shipment.
You don't have to worry, Agent. It's the softer elements I am after.
Like who?
You're beginning to exceed your clearance. What are you? Angel OA?
Excuse my persistence. I'll wait for the memo.
Good. Carry on.
Cool. Angel OA. So. Hi. Check what's here. lockpick. Is it this like the closet of switch between multi-tool and lockpick, basically? Cool.
A lot of surprises this time. Paul, a terrorist. Wow.
Well, I took out his boss. I hope that changes his mind.
I wonder what it is he found out. Why he'd defect.
He thinks he has proof of a conspiracy.
Wild stuff, huh? Hmm. I'd like to hear what he has to say. If you hear from him, or if you find out where he is, don't worry about the info link. I'll erase the archives.
You think he's right?
Worth hearing him out. I've never known Paul to make a mistake.
Okie dokie.
Manderly was tuned in when you reached the 747. It really is all over for Paul.
Okay. And again, the floor thing. Right about there. Nothing. Boo. My secret. Okay. I'm actually a little surprised there's nothing, because I don't remember what exactly every spot has at every spot, so... Cool. Also, apparently no repair bot in the area, so... Okie dokie, so that's us then going back at in the field then. I think that's all we can do here, or at least all I, you know, happen to immediately know.
So long, Agent.
For sure. There we are.
We'll miss you, Agent.
I'll miss you too, Private Lloyd. Hi, Jock.
I'm taking you to New York.
My orders are to go to Hong Kong.
Your brother's in trouble. You need to meet him in Hell's Kitchen at the apartment.
What's wrong?
I'll let him speak for himself. He just wanted me to get you to the hotel.
Mm-hmm. Cool stuff. Well, so that's a technically also could be called a mission complete moment, that one, but still.
He doesn't have much time.
I do believe you. I actually need a quick break at this point, so I'll actually take a quick break here.
Be discreet. He doesn't want any trouble with UNATCO.
Sure. So I'll take a quick break here. But if you're watching this on YouTube, I hope you've enjoyed this. And if you have, please do drop a like or a comment, or even subscribe or share if you want to. And indeed, join me here on Twitch to catch me live. And I'll hopefully see you again next time.